Welcome to Life with Kuni, Cry, and I. In my videos, I will be showing things to see and do mainly in the Brazoria County, Texas area. Some will be things that you can do anytime, some will be events that have happened. A few will be upcoming events that I will announce that I have heard about. I will try to focus on things that are more affordable and will try to include cost when I can. Please sit back and enjoy the story told by Kuni, Cry, and I.
Hi, Mama, where you been?
Hi, Kuni, I went to the Wild Peach Market tonight.
Where is that?
It is located at 21155 Highway 36, Brazoria, Texas, 77422. It is open from 5 till 9 p.m. on the last Saturday of the month. Tonight was the first market of the year. They will go until November, then will shut down for the winter months.
What did you see there, Mama?
Well, a lot of neat things, Kuni.
Like what?
What are these books about?
Depends on which book. So, this book takes place in the Beaumont area. It's about a gentleman that loses his... Uh-oh. Yeah, don't do that. Did you get it?
Yeah.
In time? Sorry. Sorry, ma'am. My phone started calling someone. Anyway, so this book is based in the Beaumont area, and it's about a gentleman who loses his boat while on a fishing trip up in the woods, and he has to walk back, and he slowly kind of starts losing his mind through dehydration. This one is a Western novel, and it's about a new preacher that comes to this town where the railroad has rerouted around it instead of going through it, and he's trying to kind of revive the town.
Are any of these true stories?
No, ma'am, unfortunately. None of these are true. They're all fiction books. Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Are you from this area?
I am now. Originally, I'm from the Beaumont area, and my wife and I live here now.
A transplant, so
yes,
am I.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So what made you come here?
I grew up here. I grew up in Brazoria.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Okay, well, good luck with your book.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine.
Good.
You make all this stuff?
Yes, the room sprays and the fresh meat, yes.
Okay. You from this area?
Yes, ma'am. I'm from Angleton.
Angleton? What are these besides?
Those are freshie hangers. You hang them from your, look, right here. You hang them from your mirror.
Uh-huh.
And it smells the car up.
Oh, butt naked?
That one smells good. You want to smell it? It's a sweet smell.
Oh, yeah.
It does smell good.
Yeah. Do you sell online?
I do not. I just go to markets and stuff like that. I haven't, it doesn't happen. I enjoy the market, so I just go to different markets and stuff, yeah.
I need a custom t-shirt.
Yeah, I should have brought some of her cards, but there's my card, and you can email me or anything like that.
Okay.
And she can do anything you want in there. Like, she made my shirt.
Okay. You see this thing in the middle of my chest?
Uh-huh.
GoPro.
Okay.
Okay, I'm making a video right now.
Okay.
I have a YouTube channel, a brand new one.
Okay.
And I'm doing a little thing out here today.
Okay, good.
You don't mind me showing any of this to you?
No, no.
Okay. And I want a little t-shirt with my logo on it.
Yeah, okay, and I want, and I almost bought that $150 one at the store. No! Exactly! I was like, I'm not gonna spend $150. And then, damn, here are y'all.
Well, then that was meant for you, then.
Hello.
Hello, are you local?
Yes, ma'am. We sure are.
Okay, so we live right in West Columbia.
You live in West Columbia.
Yes, ma'am.
What is all this stuff?
This is crystals.
Is it for anything except fun, or are you into
crystals?
Cash out. Okay.
A lot of people believe in the vibration of crystals.
Okay.
And
do you?
Yes. How they help heal our bodies and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
Yes, we believe in all of this.
Is it a religion or? I'm curious.
Spirituality.
Spirituality.
To me, it's meditation.
Yeah.
Any way you meditate, whether you meditate to God or Buddha or a higher being, whatever you believe in, it makes you feel good.
Uh-huh.
Because
meditating,
this entire earth is made out of
yes,
crystals.
You.
Uh-huh.
We're all connected. Everything is connected on this earth. Yes.
In a vibrational sense.
What?
Yes. Everything is.
What is that?
Are there anything here in the Brazoria County area that
like,
you dig for? Or?
Not. Is there anything in Brazoria County that you can dig for?
If you believe in a bad, then it's gonna bring bad.
You order all your crystals in
yes,
then?
Ma'am.
Okay.
I stand by everyone.
And
how long have you been on?
I've been doing this now for 2 years. Doing the market, I should say, for 2 years.
Okay, how long have you been into crystals?
Oh, gosh. Not that it's very basic, but 15 years now. Yeah, a long time.
And you're out
no.
here all the time?
No, ma'am.
Market all the time. We do like Jackson markets. We do this market.
Look, I'm a true believer in God, but
we've done healers markets.
Believe in religion.
We've done Oyster Creek markets. I love, especially when it comes to the kiddos.
All so pretty, though.
I love spreading the knowledge and the joy.
You're paranormal investigators, too.
Y'all know Janet? Y'all know Janet?
Do you see this thing in the middle of my chest?
She's freaking awesome.
Oh, the monitor, yeah.
I met her because.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I'm right now making a video. Would you mind if I included this?
No, go right ahead. Go right ahead.
Okay, I'm very new at YouTube.
Yeah.
But I'm doing all things Brazoria.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That is very awesome.
Yeah. So I'll probably edit this tonight or tomorrow.
No, I mean, it's not because
it's
of that.
Crystal Sage and More, Witches and Wheels.
Okay. We are called Witches on Wheels.
Witches on Wheels.
I need a five.
We also make intention jars.
I need a five.
What are intention jars?
Yeah, you're right about that, though. And I'm a
fan. Here, you want me to get it?
Yeah.
You got it.
Intention jars are what people make. We put our intentions in the jar.
Okay.
It's got...
So I know this chick,
herbs,
like, she's,
and whenever you put your intention in a jar,
maybe you know her.
You seal it with wax.
Okay.
And that seals your intention.
Okay.
She's gonna
Do you make those here with
whole,
people?
Like,
I can.
Okay.
If I bring all
but
the stuff,
like,
I can.
She does a lot
we
of
can.
Bad stuff people too.
So if people...
So she...
Come out here like next time. Can do you do that?
It was like cracked open.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there,
they can actually make it themselves and put their own intentions in. We can
down,
make a jar for
one
you,
above,
but it's
over
better
and
if
one, like,
you do
looking.
It. Okay.
Okay.
And put your own intentions.
Huh? Like the Three Stooges.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then our sales is just our sales.
What are you doing, honey?
Kai's Creations. She makes freshies, decals, stickers, wooden signs, cups, keychains, and more.
I was just thinking, I was like, we should do something like this. It's dark out.
Kind of. How are you?
Hi. You make decals?
Yes.
You make decals to put on vehicles.
Yes, they put them on vehicles, laptops, phone cases.
Can I? Are you out here all the time?
I try to be.
When did this market start? A couple
I have
years ago?
No idea. This is only my second time being here.
Okay.
Last time I was here was in November. So
okay.
I don't know when they started doing it.
Okay. How long have you been making these things?
A year.
A year?
Yes.
What got you into this?
I don't know really. I saw a lot of people doing it and I figured I wanted to try it, so I just did and here we are.
You enjoy it?
Yeah, it's really fun actually, especially the freshies. Because there's just never ending
what
things
are
that
they?
You can do. So you can put them in your car, they make your car smell good, closets, bathrooms, sock drawers, anywhere you think needs a little freshen up, that's where most people put them.
And is this your only job, or do you
right
work
now,
with...
Right now, yes, yes. Yeah. Yeah, I have one in my closet right now. My closet smells amazing.
And you've only been doing this a year. Your packaging looks wonderful.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Would you care if I would include your booth in my YouTube video?
Sure. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, along with your name and...
Yeah. I don't know if you want this side.
Hell's Creations.
This side.
This is the second.
Well,
very nice to meet you.
You too.
I hope to come out here again and I'll see what you're doing.
Yeah, next time they do this, I plan on being out here, hopefully. Because this is one of my favorite markets to be at.
Yeah. It's nice weather today.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely nice.
Yeah.
Way better than what it has been.
Yes.
Hi.
Fine. How are you?
Well, it's a perfect evening. There's almost no wind, but it's still cool. The mosquitoes are here.
Oh, yeah. And unfortunately, I'm not really a customer either. I've got this thing strapped in the middle of my chest, and I'm working. I'm making a YouTube video.
How are you? Well,
do you make all your
friends.
Stuff?
call all your friends and tell them to come here.
Well, I'm gonna post this, and then next time there's a wild peach market, maybe everybody that sees the videos will come. Which I'm brand new at YouTube, so who knows how many people that'll be.
Well, I have a YouTube.
You do? You do?
And I've had it for probably 15 years, and I probably have 3 followers.
How often do you post?
One video a year.
This channel that I'm working on today is all about stuff to go and do and see in Brazoria that is low cost.
Fantastic.
And if there's a price for anything, I'm kind of including. This is a totally free market.
Yep.
Everybody in Brazoria needs to know about it. And
it is a fabulous little market. The
people
who run it are great. It's a super cute venue. They did all of the restoration. They have the bathroom and the fountain and the big wrecking ball over there and the pretty lights, and it's just a fantastic atmosphere.
Uh-huh.
I guess everybody was graduating today.
Oh, well, I guess you need to do that one day in your life.
I guess we'll allow it.
Yeah. So do you make all the stuff?
Yes, I make everything from scratch pretty much.
The cup?
I put the pictures on the cups. I don't actually make the mug itself. So
how do you do that?
It's called sublimation. And
do you have a kiln?
No, I don't make the mug itself. I just put the pictures on it. You don't have to have a kiln to put the picture on.
Oh, okay. Now, I do ceramics, and all my decals have fire on.
So, this is, it's a sublimation printer.
Okay.
And you just print it out on a special piece of paper, you tape it on there, and you put it in a heat press for 4 minutes.
Oh, like,
that's it.
What is that, like crickets?
No. It has this little thing that heats it up and it goes around it.
Okay.
And it's just, it prints out just like a regular piece of paper. So.
How much do you charge to make mugs like that?
I charge $12 for the mugs.
$12 for the mugs.
Now, like all of the wood signs and everything, those start with a 4x8 sheet of plywood.
And you do all that?
Yes, I make that completely from scratch.
So you're a busy girl.
And then all the sun catchers above your head, all of those are completely from scratch as well.
So you must not have any other job. This is
this
it.
This is what I do, yeah.
Yeah.
This is
I used to do ceramics.
I love ceramics, and I really, really would love to get back into it.
Really?
But I haven't done it since college.
And I can mention you in my...
Yeah, okay. Absolutely.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Fine, how are you?
Good.
Do you make all this stuff?
Yes, ma'am, I do.
You know, everybody out here makes all their stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. That's neat.
I make it all by hand.
Very crafty.
Thank you.
Even dice?
Yes, ma'am.
Wow.
I won't throw anything away. If I can make something out of it, I will. It's from pallet wood. Pallets.
Pallets?
Yes, ma'am. Pallets. You know, pallets?
Yeah.
And then I said, man, I can make something with this. So I did.
Well, how long have you been doing this?
Probably about 5 years off and on while I was working. Then now I'm retired, so I got more time. I come out here and I'm with my wife. And we enjoy it. And it keeps me busy. Yeah, but I was doing the line of work I was doing. I was with pallets and the plants, and we were getting pallets all the time. I get rid of them, burn them, trash them, give them to the school for their bonfires. And I get clean ones, real nice, good wood. I make stuff out of them on my spare time. And now I do it all the time because I'm retired. So I'm going to my shop. And
you obviously do wood burning, it looks like, too.
Yes, ma'am. I burn it, I seal it, I polyurethane it, and do my own paintings. And
you do furniture too, or?
Depends on how big it is, yes. I got my card. I mean, I do a lot of big stuff, wishing wells. I do signs for businesses, and you go on there, you can see all the work I do.
Oh, okay, you have a website and everything?
Yes, it's on Facebook.
Would you mind if I'd include it?
Ma'am?
Would you mind if I'd mention it?
No, not at all.
At first, I thought she was selling silk flower arrangements. The flowers looked too perfect to be real. But they were real and hand-raised locally. I'm sure she will be successful in e-business, as she not only has a green thumb, but is good at arranging the flowers and a super photographer, easy to talk to, a super neat lady.
Are these can't be real.
They are fresh cut this morning.
They are.
Yes.
They're so pretty. Do you raise them?
Yes, ma'am.
What exactly are these?
These ones are zinnias, and then celosia, and Victoria salva, and then cosmos.
Oh, and you raise those. What do you have, a greenhouse?
No, I just have an open field that I raise them in.
Yeah, I found a bunch of garden space, and I was like, you know what, I should just find a little flower patch and throw out some wild seeds.
Bees and Blooms Farms. Where are you located?
We are located outside of Sweeney.
If I can find a place.
Outside Sweeney.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And how long have you been doing this?
This is awesome. Our first year.
First year. How do you like it?
I love it.
Is this a hobby, or are you trying to make this into a career?
I'm trying to make this into a business.
Are you going to florist and all that?
Not yet. So these are my first batch of flowers that have bloomed. So I'm just starting to sell. But pretty soon I will probably start going to florists and all sorts of people, restaurants.
The florist out there on the highway, I forget what the name of that one is. She has beautiful arrangements. She has a beautiful shop. You could get in touch with her. I forget what her name is. So, Bees and Blooms. Can I take a card? And
yes, ma'am, of course. Yeah.
Scan it and kind of put it in my videos when I show your beautiful flowers.
Yes, ma'am.
Would you mind that?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Yeah. I want to ask permission because I don't want to put up something and then have everyone say, ah!
Today, I was not able to show everything I seen as there was too much. For a video, these were a few of the things I seen. There was also barbecue, snow cones, fruit waffles, and so many vendors. Everyone was nice and super friendly. I seen no alcohol or drama amongst the people attending. It was a great atmosphere for everyone. This would be a great place to get started selling, or the expand, or your current business. I hope to see everyone I met today again, and meet some of you that are watching this video. Have a wonderful evening.
Mom, when you telling Cooney about the wild peach market, I heard you talking about the flowers and I went and got you some.
Oh, cry, I love them, thank you so much.
Oh, neat, Mama. Mama, can I ask you something?
Yes. Cooney, what is it, honey?
Can you please take a few of the flowers and make me some pancakes?
Oh, Kuni, wrong kind of flowers.